Avrupa'da tanınmış uluslararası avukat Jean Fermon, televizyonumuz muhabirlerinden Erem Kansoy'un sorularını yanıtladı. Jean Fermon, Belçika Mahkemesi'nin kararının diğer ülkelerde de Kürtler tarafından mahkemelerde ortaya koyulması gerektiğini hatırlattı.
Of course, a decision of a Belgian court does not have immediate precedent, effect of precedent in other countries. But I think in the defense of Kurdish activists prosecuted in other countries, lawyers and the solidarity movement can rely on that decision to try to break more or less the almost automatic decision that the PKK is to be considered as a terrorist organization. So I think this can be very useful in other countries to argue that the different approach is needed to the conflict.
PKK'nin listeye alınmasındaki en büyük sebeplerden birinin Türkiye'nin bir NATO üyesi olması olduğunu hatırlatan Fermon, "Eğer Türkiye ile savaşıyorsanız NATO ile de dolaylı yönden savaşıyorsunuz anlamına gelir." dedi.
And I think the basic reason why PKK was listed as a terrorist organization is because Turkey is a NATO country and so fighting the Turkish state is in fact indirectly fighting NATO and therefore NATO countries listed PKK as a terrorist organization.
Is it political that still the PKK is in the list?
I think it's for purely political reasons. When the Belgian court decided in 2020 that PKK was not a terrorist organization but a party to a civil war and therefore was not the anti-terrorist law did not apply to PKK but that the laws of war applied to the whole conflict. Immediately the Belgian government made a statement the next day saying that the executive, the government, would continue to consider PKK as a terrorist organization. And that was a clearly political stand.
Avukat Jean Fermon son olarak PKK'nin listeden çıkarılması yönünde devletlerin üzerinde ciddi bir baskı oluşturmak adına Kürt aktivistlerin büyük organizasyonlarla çalışmalar yürütmesi gerektiğini vurguladı.
Members of the Kurdish community, I think they should more, instead of working within the community, work with other people, work with the trade unions, work with the youth organizations, work with on a massive scale. There are probably millions of Kurds in Europe. That is, the South Africans didn't have millions of South Africans in Europe. And still they succeeded to have this massive anti-apartheid campaign. So I think the Kurds should really have a strategy of working with big European popular organizations, the trade unions, youth organizations, women organizations, to build this massive movement, build up this massive movement of pressure on the governments to stop supporting the Turkish authorities and to at least consider the Kurds as an equal party in that situation.